The 2004 Toyota 4Runner Limited N210. This model is part of the fourth generation of the 4Runner, which has been in production for 38 years and counting. It was labeled as a mid-size sport utility vehicle, and at the time of sale was Toyota's most capable off-roading vehicle. The 2004 4Runner, as well as every 4Runner before it and after it, was built in Japan, contributing to its stellar reliability. The exterior of the 2004 model is done just right. It avoids looking too soft while also not being overly aggressive like some modern SUVs. The limited trim gives you 17-inch alloy rims upgraded from the 16-inch rims on the SR5 trim, and also comes with silver illuminated running boards and silver roof rails. Besides that, the exterior remains very similar for all trims, with an exception of a hood scoop on the Sport Edition. The interior of this car is good for a 2004 model. This being the limited trim, it comes with heated leather seats which are power adjustable. The steering wheel and shift knob are leather wrapped, adding to the general comfort of your drive. The leather inside isn't great, but it is just a Toyota, so you can't expect much. Many think of the 4Runner as a large SUV, but you wouldn't think so if you were sitting in the back seats. Though the back seats may be a nice place for a smaller person, with rear ventilation, soft leather seats, and a JBL sound system, you forget about all of that if you're squeezed in. I am 6'1", sitting behind myself, and I struggle to get in, and once I'm in, I feel like I have negative legroom. I do, though, have enough headroom, but it's an SUV, so that should come without saying. Despite the lack of legroom, the 4Runner manages to have plenty of storage space in the trunk. The rear storage space contains many tie-down points to mount down any large item you please. If you wanted more storage, though, in less than a minute you could fold down the rear seats flat. With the seats down, the cargo area increases from 41 cubic feet to 73 cubic feet of space. You could even spend the night in the back if you needed, as long as you weren't too tall, with 68 inches or just under 6 feet of length from the back of the front seats to the trunk door. Now it's time to get under the hood. In the 2004 4Runner, we have the 4.0-liter 1GR FE V6, which produces 245 horsepower and 282 pound-feet of torque. The power from this engine leads right to an unflattering but reliable 4-speed automatic transmission. This engine has been used in the 4Runner ever since 2002 and is still used today in the 2022 model year. Because of the mass production of the 4-liter V6, this car is easy and cheap to repair and has allowed it to prove its reliability for years. Driving this car just feels good. You're high up, have good visibility, the seats are comfortable, and you feel safe. In 2004, the 4Runner had one of the lowest death rates, with only a few models outperforming it. The 256 horsepower V6 engine pulls this SUV to 60 miles per hour in just 8 seconds, which isn't bad for a 4,100 pound SUV like the 4Runner. To put that in perspective, this is the same 0 to 60 time as the 2021 Toyota Corolla and the 2021 Lexus IS250, two much newer and much smaller cars. The downfall to the driving experience, though, is the transmission. Being only a 4-speed, the automatic transmission tends to search for gears a little too much going up hills. The 2004 model year was the last year of the 4-speed, with only the 5-speed auto being available from 2005 onwards, which was a large improvement. Road performance is one thing, but where this vehicle really excels is off-road. The 2004 4Runner comes equipped with four-wheel drive, low and high, an electronically locking limited slip differential, and an independent double wishbone front suspension. With 8.9 inches of ground clearance, this vehicle will handle perfectly on any dirt road you can find, as long as you have the right tires. Overall, the 2004 Toyota 4Runner is a great vehicle with outstanding reliability. Getting your hands on one today may be expensive and difficult, but if you get lucky, I overwhelmingly recommend you jump on the opportunity and hold on to it. Well, like always, if you enjoyed this video and want more car reviews and car history, please like and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one.